That's a lot, brother. That's a lot. All right, so I got an answer for the cockiness, though, and it would, as with all things that I love about sports, it has nothing to do with the sport itself, right? It is oil, in a word, all right? And this is going back, I mean, you could take this to Manziel, you could take it even further back. But they were able to turn wildcatting into large sums of money, not unlike Jerry Jones, right? And what he did, basically drilling holes in the ground in Oklahoma and forging his fortune big enough to buy the Dallas Cowboys, and we know what happened after that. But you're talking about a group of folks that went to the same college that drilled holes in the ground and wanted nothing more than to have an outstanding football team. The same thing happened at Southern Methodist in the early 80s. They got tired of hearing Texas A&M's mouth, hearing Texas's mouth, because they were also benefiting from oil money. So when you're able to have all this cash on hand and all these reserves on hand, you believe that you can do what the LA Dodgers have, you know, claimed to have done, right? They actually grow some of their players, but they can also go spend all this money on Mookie Betts. And they're in the World Series 3 out of the last 4 years. They get one last night. Kudos to them. But they also got all this money to go buy Mookie Betts with, and to keep Justin Turner on the payroll and to keep Corey Seager on the payroll. A&M set out to do the same thing, okay? They tried to do it with Eric Dickerson. Eric Dickerson took the Trans Am, drove it all the way back up to Southern Methodist, right? Like, that's what it is. They're going, we ought to be able to buy these players. We ought to be able to buy the best coaches. They spent $75 million in 10 years on Jimbo Fisher because they believe they should be able to buy these things. And nobody is happier because they got money. You're more secure. You know, you feel like you could take care of some stuff, but you're not happier because nobody's happy about anything they didn't earn, right? If you didn't have to work for it, it doesn't mean anything at all to you. Ampersand you lives and breathes this. They spend all this money on Kyle Field believing that it's going to, and I'm quoting the chancellor here, we want our opponents to piss in their pants when they step foot in here and see and hear the 12th man. Problem with that is most of the teams that they're playing, whether it be the Big 12 or now the SEC, ain't scared of a damn thing because they had to go out and earn this everywhere else, as if ampersand U is the only university that has an enormous stadium that they can fill. More than that, when you hear about how some of these other coaches come up and you hear about what they have to say about what Jimbo Fisher and his staff gets paid, yeah, hell, they're going to go out recruit them. And they're going to want nothing more than to beat them up. Now, what I find to be just a little bit inspiring about ampersand U is they don't care that the rest of us dislike them. They prefer it that way. Not unlike Notre Dame in that way, right? They prefer to be us against everybody. Problem with that is when you don't win like Alabama, when you don't have, you know, a year every 5 to 6 years like LSU, when you don't give anything to the rest of us for us to be happy about and proud of, we don't like you. Even Johnny Manziel. There were people that really wanted to ride for Johnny Football, and they made it impossible because they were making themselves even more insufferable because they got one win against Alabama, and they stomped a mud hole in Oklahoma in the Cotton Bowl. After that, what have they done except run off Kevin Sumlin and screw up Kyler Murray? Like, this is the part that I really get upset about.
You mean the guy that beat Russell Wilson on Monday Night Football, you somehow, some way screwed him? How did that happen? He didn't lose a high school football game, RJ.
Dude!
He didn't lose the game!
43-0! 43-0! And by anybody's account, quite literally the best high school quarterback who ever lived, right? And his daddy was a quarterback for your Aggies. Like, in 88. Like, he was the man. And the way that the Aggies fans treated what was the first black quarterback that they had resonated with his father, Kevin, and with his uncle, Calvin. And yet, and still, they still gave him an opportunity. They still sent him to ampersand U. And then they try to throw Kyle Allen out there, right? And Kyler's like, okay, first of all, this ain't the offense that I wanted to run. And I thought this was going to be my job. Number two, I want to play baseball. Come to find out, his high school coach went to Lincoln Riley when he first got the job and said, hey, Kyler's looking to transfer. What do you think? I think he should sign us the financial aid agreement with Oklahoma right now. And he browbeat him into it. He signs it, and they give all these stipulations. They say, we're going to play baseball? Cool. We only guarantee 1 year of football? Cool. But I think, you know, if we get an offer to play baseball, we're going to take it. And Riley said, as long as I get that 1 year, I'm good. And they kept their word. Even after getting drafted number 9 overall, they kept their word, and that ended up being, you know, the best choice for everybody. But that could have been you, ampersand you. That could have been y'all. And instead, what do we get? We get them trying to claim Kyler Murray as a Heisman winner. That is what I will not ever understand, because I don't want anybody else's stuff, man. I don't want to claim anybody else's stuff. I want to get it myself. And that's one of the things that I like most about Arkansas football, right? Nobody at Arkansas is claiming that they would be better in another league. Nobody at Arkansas is claiming that they would go beat up on the American teams. They're saying, no, we're in the SEC West. We want to win in the SEC West. We were really good. Turned 2011? Number 3 in the country? Do I have that right? Is that the highest rank?
Correct. Lost the number 1 LSU on the road when they were number 3 in the country.
And that team played in a national championship, right?
Correct. You know the other team they lost to that year?
It's Bama?
Bama.
Yeah.
The only 2 teams in the national championship.
Golly.
That's what Arkansas lost to that year.
Nah, man, but that's how it is. That's what it is to play in that division of that league. And now we're in this place where it feels like the defense is carrying Arkansas, dog. Like, and I'm not used to that. I've never been around for Arkansas football's defense being what you hang your hat on. Is that how you feel?
You're 100% right, and there's a lot that we have to unpack there. Number one, you speak of the coaches that Texas A&M hired. You mentioned Dickerson. There's Dennis Francione. There's Mike Sherman. Now mm-hmm. Jimbo Fisher, Kevin Sullivan. There's a lot of guys that got paid good money. And by the way, Jimbo's contract, for those who don't know, he does not have a buyout if he leaves the school. Now, if he gets fired, he has a fat lump sum that's coming his way. But if he leaves for another job, doesn't owe the university a cent. So his AD, I don't know if it's why am I forgetting the best agent in sports? Jimmy Sexton. I don't know if it's Sexton, but whoever his agent is did a tremendous job.
It is.
With that.
It is Jimmy. It is Jimmy, okay. Sexton. Yeah.
If you throw a dart at the wall, and a lot of times it lands on Jimmy Sexton. And to your point about the coaches wanting to be there or not, Sam Pittman, while he didn't grow up at the University of Arkansas, grew up in Grove, Oklahoma, about 90 miles from Fayetteville, loved the University of Arkansas, coached as an offensive line coach, and then got the opportunity. Players advocated for him to come. And his contract, RJ, is incentive-based. He doesn't just get the money that he's get, like he has one of the lowest, if not the lowest, contracts base pays in the SEC. But the incentive is, hey, Sam, you keep winning games, you're going to get paid more. That's what jobs and capitalism is all about, based on your performance. It's almost like, hold up, stop traffic. Hunter, you're checking his team, and then Judy Henry, who his agent is down there in Little Rock, they actually came together and decided, hey, we want Arkansas football to be good. Let's give Sam reasons to make them good. And listen, money's not the end-all be-all for Sam. If it was, he would ask for more. His plans are, I don't know if you know this, he's going to retire in Hot Springs, Arkansas, and Lake Hamilton. Went there last weekend during the bye week. But that has to be a passion if you want to coach at Arkansas. Houston Nutt had it. Frank Broyles had it. Ken Hatfield had it. There's other coaches along the lineage of football and basketball. Nolan Richardson, most notably in basketball, had it. That's important. You can't really find that throughout the history of Texas A&M.